Let's talk politics. Why don't we specifically the Oregon legislature? Because there is a battle happening there right now. I know it's hard to keep track of all this stuff with everything else going on. But, you know, this battle is kind of different because it's not between Democrats and Republicans. It's between these two Democrats. Representative Janelle Bynum is challenging House Speaker Tina Kotek for her leadership position. See, Kotek's been the speaker for 7 years now. She's been reelected every 2 years by her own party. And until Bynum threw her hat in the ring, everyone pretty much assumed that Kotek was going to be a shoo-in once again. But before we get into all this, I want to explain to you why it matters and why you should care. See, the Oregon House Speaker is an incredibly powerful position. They control basically the legislative agenda in many ways, and that means what bills get introduced and what gets voted on. And right now, with the Democrats holding a supermajority, that means that they can control basically what gets passed. So if there's something you really care about, maybe it's homelessness or health care or racial justice, see, the speaker plays a big part in deciding whether our lawmakers focus on that. So let's take a look at why Bynum is challenging Kotek and what it really could mean for Oregon politics.
So we're watching something that's happening that hasn't really happened very much in Oregon history. So it's a kind of an interesting moment.
Our KGW political analyst, Len Bergstein, says usually these kinds of battles within parties play out behind closed doors, but now this one's right out in the open. On Monday night, Democrats did meet privately to pick a nominee for speaker, and at that point, only Kotek put her name forward. She got the nomination from her party, but according to the Oregonian, did not secure all 31 votes she needed to be reelected when the full House votes in January. And that's when Bynum announced she'd be challenging.
It must mean she's going to try and go get some votes from the Republicans, which means that she'll have to have some sort of power sharing with the Republicans. They'll want something.
That could mean Republicans getting control of a committee or getting a bill passed that they really want. That's not something Democrats expected to have to concede with their current supermajority. Here's what Bynum told us when we asked her why she wanted to be House Speaker.
Every time people of color come into the Capitol, literally or figuratively, they're on their knees. It's not from a position of power. It's not from a position of how can I add to the conversation. It's always a very, it's from a position of need, deep, deep, deep need. And I felt that I wanted to change that perspective. I wanted to make sure that people always felt that they knew that the Capitol was their house, that they could make demands of it from a position of strength.
Right now, she's the chair of the House Judiciary Committee, which is a pretty powerful position. This year, she's been a driving force for passing police accountability laws. But that's not her only agenda. As speaker, she says she would focus on mental health, housing, help for small businesses, and graduation rates for communities that are suffering.
And I think that just comes from knowing that someone is there who is friendly to their cause, who understands the needs of communities of color, rural communities, marginalized communities.
Despite her record on police reform, Bynum has taken more moderate positions than Kotek on some issues. And she says, as a rule, she always works across the aisle whenever she's trying to get a bill passed. Kotek didn't give us an interview, but released a statement on her nomination that didn't mention Bynum's challenge at all. It says in part, I'm honored to have the support of my caucus to continue serving Oregon and the chamber as House Speaker. Like every business and family in Oregon, the legislature has been moving from crisis to crisis since February. I remain committed to continue working with every member to help all parts of the state to solve these immense challenges. Earlier this week, Kotek called for a special session in December to focus on economic recovery. Her office also pointed to her accomplishments as speaker. Over the past year, those include passing the Student Success Act, paid and family medical leave, rent stabilization, Medicaid funding, and police use of force reform. But some are wondering exactly how long Kotek is going to stick around.
So there's a question about whether she might be an attractive candidate for the Biden administration. And so people start thinking, well, gee, maybe there's a power vacuum kind of evolving. And so people are trying to get in line.
We asked Bynum about that. Here's what she said.
You know what I think is the bigger factor is the gubernatorial election that's coming up in 2 years.
She didn't elaborate, but we know Kotek's name has been floated as a candidate in 2022 when Governor Kate Brown's final term ends.